Hey guys, Mark back here. Okay, so I'm back working on this empty tomb painting. And now I want to start to fill in this area here. Taking some, I'm using a color, it's called brown gray. Brown gray, a little bit of black. Okay. Grayish brownish color. Not overmixed in the palette knife. Leave it kind of marbled. And so I'm going to come in here and poke in some color. And this is going to be underneath. It's going to be a little bit darker up in here. Just going to apply in that. I got a little bit of dry paint in there. That happens sometimes. Just kind of move it around, spread it around, get it in there. Comes over here, it's a little bit lighter as it comes down. Now, you need to watch out the edge of this this stone that's covering it. Kind of go right around that there, like that. A little white. Not over mixing the paint and letting a lot of variations be in there. Excuse my arm for a second while I come this way. I can make a nice straight edge that overlaps that area there. That rock overlaps where it's empty. Pull it down. Here, oops. Put this up here like I usually do just to make it a little easier. I do paint on canvas or stretch canvas. The only reason why I paint on these boards is because it's a little bit cheaper to ship. Stretch canvas are really expensive to ship. And sometimes people don't want to buy my paintings when they have to pay that much shipping. So sometimes I paint on these. If I paint on a commission, usually it's on a stretch canvas, so no matter what. This looks a little bit better on a stretch canvas. If I can kind of shape this edge here a little bit better. A little bit darker up here. As you get better at using the knife, you get better at loading certain parts of the knife. Like right there, I just loaded the right side of the knife. So the whole knife. Bring that together a little bit. Pull it down here a little bit better. Give the wife a little bit of a wipe. Knife a little bit of a wipe. Take some white. Warm it up a little bit. Some more of that brown gray. Right in here as a lighter color. Down. This is the step. Let me get a little bit more weight. Get rid of that there. There's a little bit of dried paint in there. I don't want that on there. Most of this is underpainting. Shows the edge of that step. Brown, gray, white, and black. Probably gonna have to let this whole painting dry and go over it again with details. So you can paint in layers even if it's a not palette knife painting. You know? Some law that says you can't. Usually palette knife paintings are in one a la prima stage, but this painting seems like it's going to need some layers to get some detail in here. That's why it helps to let it dry. Down here it's a little bit darker, a little bit more brown with gray, with black. More of a darker color down here. Put this forward a little bit better, a better angle. Right up to where that step is. A lot of paint on the knife. Not overmixed. Find enough in places. It's gonna have a lot of variation in there, but not overmixing. To that step. I'll move this over a little bit here. I got that a little bit too much to the right where it overlaps. I don't want that to be to the right that much. Filled in. Filled in. Yeah, I'll get it a little bit dark over here. Over there, over here. Wipes the knife. I just wipe it once in a while so I get some fresh color on there. Now we have a little bit of a dark area in there I need to fill in. Up in there. Oops. And then right down to that step. Into that empty tomb area. Good. Starting to get that feeling in there. And you have that side of the stone there. See if I can get this painted in. I think I made that stone a little bit too light and have to darken it a little. See if I can get the edge. Paint it in there. It's a little bit too dark, but that's alright. Play with it afterwards. Get it dark lighter. Maybe it's too many details, but I want to lighten the edge of that so it doesn't, it sets it off a little bit more. Not too many details at this point. Over this a little bit so it's not quite as bright. It's a little bit too bright in there. I don't mind it being light, it's just not hyper light, a little bit too light. Good. Good enough for now. I don't want to mess with it too much right now. Now, we have down over here, we have some darker color, a little bit more of that green color. Fill it in a little bit darker right in there. More dark. So it gets more recessed. Under there, more dark up over here. Under these, just a shadow here. Tie that together. I'm gonna grab a paper towel so I can wipe my knife off a little bit. Be right back. Some of those formations on the right side. And here, grab a little bit of that brown gray. Change up the color a little. It's not a color I use much. I use it a lot in this painting. Mix in with that, gray color. And then you have some of these rocks over here in the back. Rock on that way, rock going up. It's going to be really impossible to put all these details in unless you let it dry and then go back. That's what I'm going to do. This is an Easter painting, so hopefully I'll have it done by Easter. I should let it dry quickly enough. White, more black. Where's my black? There it is. When you're taking paint out of a tube, always squeeze it from the very end. Get that paint out of there from the. Don't squeeze it from the top because you're not going to get it from the top, the side. Paint is expensive, we need to get as much out of there as we can, eh? This particular brand isn't too bad price. And dark down here. I don't want to make that dark. I'm really putting a lot of paint on there. This is like another stone shape. Rolls in front, I think. And over here is more of a round shape, so I'll sort of like that. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's another stone or what it's supposed to be. Light over on this side. More highlight on there. Filled in pretty good. Underneath this is more dark under there. Here it's darker. Close that way. Just getting a feel of a few details here and there, not too many. I'll work on that more. Right here, maybe a little line that goes there. Alright, so back up in here is a little bit more shadow. Put that on there, get the shadow going this way a little bit more. Back in my light color. Oops, I didn't get light there. Anyway, here, this needs to be lighter up in here. Texture. This side more texture. White and gray. More dark in the bottom. The side on the right is a little bit too busy for me. I don't want it that busy. So I'm going to work on that, kind of calm that down a little. Just going to blend it out a little bit more. It's not that busy looking. There's a stone there, there's a stone right there. that so overwhelming there with those shadows. Shadow in that step. Set that off a little bit more. Right here, make that dark. I'm going to stop there. And what I'm going to do now is just let this completely dry. Completely dry. There's a lot of thick paint on there. But if I completely let it dry, then go over it with details, it'll look a lot better in the end. As opposed to me just playing with it and keep trying to improve it and everything. It's gonna all mix together, it's not gonna look good. If I let it dry, it's gonna look better in the end. In here, I want this a little light. A little bit light in the inside the tomb there. It's not 100% black. Okay, that was better. And a little bit. Alright, so hope you guys enjoyed this one. I'll be back next time working on that other painting. What is it, the square lighthouse? I'll be back with that one next time, but for now, I'll let this dry. It's going to take a couple days, and I'll come back to this one. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.